Hi there, and welcome to a new episode of the Meet the Expert vlog. My name is Michelle, and I work at Van der Landen as a sales engineer. But you might already know me from my previous vlog about the Goods to Picker workstation. I just received these shoes, which I ordered online, but I'm afraid they're a little bit too small for me. So I think I have to return them. But how do companies actually deal with these returns? That's what we are going to explore today. I'm going to call Paul Tone because he knows everything about handling returns. Hi, Paul. How are you?
Hi, Michelle. I'm fine. And yourself?
Yeah, also good. I just ordered these shoes online, but unfortunately they are too small, so I have to return them. But I was curious, how does it work, the return process at companies? I see you are in the office. Is it okay if I come by?
Yeah, sure, come by, drop by, then I can show it to you.
Okay, see you over there.
Ah, nice shoes. Pity that they don't fit.
Thank you, yes, unfortunately.
Hey, but you'd like to know more about returns handling.
Yeah, I can imagine with the growing e-commerce market nowadays that then the number of returns is also drastically increasing.
Yeah, a lot of companies struggle with the huge amount of returns flowing back into their warehouses. It's a costly process. So our customers are looking for ways to make this process more efficient.
So if I would return these shoes, what would the process be at the company?
Yeah, it's actually a series of activities. So it starts with a pickup at your house or at the drop-off point. And then in the warehouse, the box is opened, the items are taken out and checked if they have been worn or used or maybe damaged. They will be packed as if they were brand new. So there will be a new foil around it, a new box. Because when you buy online, you also don't expect smelly shoes in a dirty box.
No, I would not like that, no. And
finally, the items are put back into storage. And if they are reordered again, a person has to go back and pick them.
So what can Van der Landen do to help with the handling of returns?
Well, one solution that we offer is called AirPick. Mm-hmm. And that involves a pocket system. And actually, I can show that to you.
Oh, yes.
So the returned item is put into a pocket. And then the pocket is automatically transported to a storage area. Mm-hmm. And once the item is resold again, the item comes back automatically to the packing table. And this saves a lot of walking time and picking time in the storage area.
And what are the other benefits of AirPick?
Well, it makes the picking much more efficient because you can pick large groups of items. At the same time, you significantly reduce the amount of walking in the large warehouses.
And what kind of items can be put into this pocket system?
Fashion items like t-shirts and shoe boxes very nicely fit into the pocket. But also hanging garments can be put onto the pocket. And it can also carry multimedia devices like telephones or even homeware. And our AirTrax technology brings all the pockets into full sequence. Both e-com orders and large shop orders, such that the packing operator can pack all the items in one carton.
And what is AirTrax exactly?
Well, AirTrax is our overhead conveying technology, mm-hmm. and it uses a robust carrier design and a friction-driven drive to have the highest availability with the lowest possible maintenance effort and cost. And next to that, it allows you to make maximum use of the building height.
And for what customers is this solution a good fit?
Well, Van der Landen designed systems based on the needs and the characteristics of our customers. Would you like to see how that works?
Okay, yes, that would be fun.
Well, you can go over to our sales engineering department. Mm-hmm. Sander is working at a very nice project at the moment. I can give him a call if you like.
Yeah, good. Don't forget my shoes, of course. Bye, Paul.
Bye.
Hi, Sander.
Hi, Michelle. I was already expecting you.
Yes, I was just talking to Paul, and he told me you are the expert on designing of AirPick solutions.
Well, I'm not sure about that, but as a sales consultant, it's my job to design the best automated warehouse solutions for our potential customers.
But how do you design an AirPick system for a particular customer?
Well, together with the customer, we identify business cases to automate warehouse solutions. And this results in the design requirements for a solution.
So do you have an example of such a solution?
Yeah, sure. So I'll show you on the screen.
Yes. So what are the requirements of this system and how did you incorporate those into the design?
Well, the first requirement is to achieve a system throughput of 8,000 items per hour. We can achieve it with a one module AirTrax pocket system that has a system capacity of 8,000 items per hour as well.
Okay, so then 8,000 pockets are passing by per hour.
Yeah, 8,000 pockets with an item in it.
Okay, yes, of course, yeah.
The second requirement of this customer was to have a really high system availability. It really helps that we don't need to tension or lubricate any chains. Because we don't work with chains, we work with friction drives to drive the system.
And are there also returns handled inside of the system?
Yeah, to handle the return rate of 30% for this particular customer, we designed a so-called pocket storage area. This can hold 75,000 items.
Yes. Okay, that's a lot. So what if I would return my shoes to this warehouse?
Well, your shoes will be delivered by a truck to one of these dock doors. And over here is the quality area, where the quality of your shoes will be checked. And then your shoes will be loaded into a pocket, and the pocket will end up here on the top floor in the pocket storage area. All the items in these pockets are likely to be sold within the next 24 hours. And then the pocket with the item will be taken out, will be packed over here in a parcel, and then will be shipped over here via the trucks to a new customer.
Okay, so that's good news. Then I feel less guilty about returning my shoes, of course. I hope you now know what can happen to a product if you would return it. If you have any other questions about our warehousing activities, you can place them in the comments. And don't forget to press the like button, of course. I'm now going home to order some new shoes online.